Hello everyone, now I am going to discuss class 7 chapter 4. In last video we have learned about the chapter 3, which was the fiber to fabric. In this video we are going to read about chapter 4, the chapter is heat. So when you listen the heat, what things come to in your mind? I hope you must have think about the warm, cold, hot, so what is heat? How we can feel the heat, or how we can say that, how we can define that heat? So what is heat? In this chapter we will learn about the heat. Firstly, we learn about the temperature. What is temperature? When we think about heat, in our mind strikes temperature. What is temperature? Suppose there are two things, a boiling water in any bowl or any ice cube which is obtained from fridge, refrigerator when you obtain. But if you touch your finger while the boiling water and after that you touch the ice which is obtained from the refrigerator, then what do you think? You feel something different when you touch the boiling water or when you touch the ice. Then what is temperature? You get the difference when you touch the boiling water or ice. When you touch, you feel cold. When you touch the ice, you feel coldness. And when you touch the boiling water by your fingers, you feel that this is hot. So from where the temperature comes? Then what is temperature? If we measure any object hotness or coldness, then that term is known as temperature. What is temperature? Measure of hotness or coldness of the body is known as temperature. This is measure of what is temperature? Measure of hotness or coldness of a body is known as temperature. So you have must read about this in your length. As length is measured in meter, so in which unit temperature is measured? Temperature is measured in degree Celsius. It is denoted by degree C. There are another unit of measuring the temperature. These are degree Celsius, Kelvin, and Fahrenheit. So there are three measuring of temperature. There are three different types of parameters from which we measure the temperature. What are Celsius, Kelvin, and Fahrenheit? Okay. Now, how we measure the temperature of body in Celsius, Kelvin, and Fahrenheit? In next, by which device we measure the temperature? The device is thermometer. Thermometer. By thermometer we measure the temperature of any object. It is of two types. Types are, first is clinical thermometer. So what is clinical thermometer? We measure the body temperature by the clinical thermometer. It is often used in medical purposes. So what is clinical thermometer? Clinical thermometer, we measure the body temperature by the clinical thermometer. In degree Celsius or Fahrenheit, there are something parameters or measurement are written on the thermometer. And what is the range of clinical thermometer? The range of clinical thermometer is35 degrees Celsius to 42 डिग्री सेल्सियस. वी मेक 35 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू 42 डिग्री सेल्सियस. वी मेजर द बॉडी टेम्परेचर बाय द क्लिनिकल थर्मामीटर. वन मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग यू नो हियर, एंड व्हाट इज आवर एवरेज नॉर्मल बॉडी टेम्परेचर? एनीवन ऑफ यू नो इट इज 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस. हाउ मच इज इट? 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस नॉर्मल बॉडी टेम्परेचर ऑफ एनी ह्यूमन बींग. ओके, सो व्हाट इज टेम्परेचर? मेजर आर हॉटनेस आर कोल्डनेस ऑफ एनी बॉडी. फ्रॉम विच वी मेजर द टेम्परेचर? वी मेजर टेम्परेचर इन देयर आर थ्री डिफरेंट यूनिट, सेल्सियस, केल्विन एंड फारेनहाइट. ओके, नाउ फ्रॉम विच वी मेजर द टेम्परेचर? वी मेजर द टेम्परेचर बाय थर्मामीटर. थर्मामीटर इज आर टू टाइप्स. फर्स्ट इज क्लिनिकल थर्मामीटर. आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट द क्लिनिकल थर्मामीटर. व्हाट इज द रेंज ऑफ क्लिनिकल थर्मामीटर? दिस इज 35 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू 42 डिग्री सेल्सियस. एंड नॉर्मल बॉडी टेम्परेचर ऑफ एन ह्यूमन बॉडी इज 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द अनदर टाइप ऑफ थर्मामीटर विच इज नोन एज लेबोरेटरी थर्मामीटर. ओके, नाउ लेट्स. So when we have to measure the body temperature, we use the clinical thermometer. And when we have to measure the temperature of any other object or the temperature beyond the limit, what was the range of clinical thermometer? It was 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. So if any temperature is beyond this temperature, we measure the temperature by another type of thermometer which is also known as laboratory thermometer. Laboratory thermometer. In laboratory thermometer. So, what is the range of laboratory thermometer? It will be different from clinical thermometer. The range of clinical thermometer was 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius, but the range of laboratory thermometer is minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. You know, this is minus 10. And what was in the clinical thermometer? It was 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. Means lowering than 35 degrees Celsius is minus 10. How much more temperature you can imagine that? To 110 degrees Celsius, very hot object when you see. So in lab there are different types of substance which we have to use. Temperature we have to measure, and that are measured by the laboratory thermometer. Now we are going to discuss about the next thing. How the temperature transfer from one place to another place. So next topic in this is transfer of heat. How heat is transferred? Have you touched any object which is hot or cold? You must have observed about the temperature. But how it transfer of heat? How the transfer of heat takes place? So there are three modes of transfer of heat. One is conduction. Conduction. Other is convection, and third is radiation. There are three modes of heat transfer. How many modes are? Three modes of heat transfer. So when the transfer of heat takes place within a body from one end to another end, then this is called conduction. Suppose you take a metal rod or any iron rod and you start heating its one end. After some time you feel that its other end also gets heated. So heat is transferred from the body of the iron or iron rod from one end to another end. Then this type of transfer of heat is known as conduction. What is conduction? Transfer of heat. Transfer of heat. from one key to another key to a body. And conduction. Conduction, it takes place in which object? You know, in which object? Suppose you have taken an iron rod. You start heating one end of the iron rod. And another you take a wooden block. You start heating the wooden block on the other end. Then the second end of the wooden block does not heat. It means the heat is not transferred in wood and the heat takes transfer in the iron. So there are two types of material which are conductor and second are insulator. What is conductor? The materials which allow to pass heat are known as conductor and this is known as conduction. And material which does not allow to pass heat are known as insulator. So you must have known about conductor and insulator. What are the example of conductor? Any metal piece, metal, suppose iron, copper, that are conductor. And insulator, wood, stone are insulator. So this was the first mode of heat transfer, that are conduction. And now we are going to discuss about the another mode of heat transfer, which is known as convection. So what is convection? In conduction you see about that the heat is transferring between a medium. It needs a medium. The medium is solid. And in convection what happens? In convection what happens? You see, you put some water in a bowl and you put that on the gas burner and light up the burner. You know what happened after some time? When the heat is started, heat flame come in contact of the bowl, then the water in the bowl also start heating, and the other end of the bowl or water is also heating. So in which the fluid is any medium or water, gas or medium, then the convection, which mode is convection. When the medium is any fluid, then this type of heat transfer is convection. Now you see an example. You light a candle. This is the flame of the candle. And you burn this candle like up. Then what happens? You put your first hand outside, top side, and second hand on the other side of the candle. Then what do you feel? You feel that the hand which is on the top of the candle is more hot. Then what happens? See, when the air is warm, then it rises up. And when the air is cold, it gets down. It becomes more dense. Or when the air is hot, then it is less dense and it moves upside. And when the air is cold, it becomes more dense and it goes down. So there are two phenomena I am going to discuss. Land bridge and sea bridge. Firstly, I will tell you about sea bridge. Sea and bridge. What is bridge? Bridge means blowing out the air. In the coastal area, there are so many sand on the land. When the sun's light falls on the earth, the ground, the earth becomes more hot in the coastal area very rapidly. Then what happens? The warmer air goes up. And when the warmer air goes up, the colder air from the sea take their place, rises out and take their places. And the cold wind blows. That phenomenon is known as seaweed. And seaweed often, this phenomenon is, takes place in daytime. In which time? Daytime. What happens? When the land gets heated rapidly, the warmer air goes up and the colder air from the seaside rises out to fill the places of the warm air, and in this way a breeze is blown, that is known as sea breeze. You must have asked, in the coastal area, the people of the coastal area make the windows of their house facing towards the sea. This is the main reason about the sea breeze. And now next phenomenon is land breeze. I am telling you about this because these phenomena are based on the convection. So in land breeze, what happened? In night, where this phenomena takes place? This phenomena takes place in night. Then what happened? In night, the water takes more time to cool down and the land gets cool easily. Then what happened? The sea and the air from the land to sea blows very easily. Then this phenomena is known as land breeze. Now ready. Now the third mode of heat transfer is radiation. What is radiation? The sun, the light or the heat from the sun comes to the earth by the mode of radiation. Which mode is this? Radiation. The sunlight comes on the earth by which mode? Mode of radiation. Now, when radiation takes place, a body gets heated. When radiation takes place, when the sum of light falls on that body, some part of it gets reflected back. That is known as reflected. And some part of the light absorbed by the body and some part of the light or heat is emitted by the body. So, when the body absorbs more heat, it temperatures become more. So that's why radiation in it is a phenomenon also of absorbance. That's why we wear the light clothes in the summer season and we wear the dark clothes in the winter season. Now we will discuss the next chapter in your next video, and this is the whole chapter of 4. Thank you.